In this video, we're going to talk a little bit about what a set point is and how they work. And I think the easiest way to think about what a set point is to simply think of it as a step in a process. And each individual step is going to have certain criteria that has to be met before we can move on to the next step. And the criteria can come in one of three different ways. It can either be based on the weight, it can be based on a certain amount of time, or it can be based on certain conditions of the scale. And we can configure the set points to be a part of what we would call a batch routine, or we can configure them to operate independently or outside of a batch routine. In this little setup here, I've created a very small and simple batch routine. It has two set points in it, the first of which is a weight-based set point. The scale is a 10,000-pound scale that counts by one-pound increments, and we have a set point that is for 4,750 pounds. And so when we start the batch, we can go ahead and do that now. We notice it says batch running down there in the lower right-hand corner. And so right now, the first set point is being evaluated. It's looking for that 4,750 pounds, and it's not going to move on to the next set point until that criteria has been met. And so when we do meet that criteria, it'll move to the next configured set point, which is a time-based set point. And I've got a light that's wired up to this, and that second set point is going to activate the light for a total of 3 seconds, and then that 3-second time frame is the criteria. So once that time has expired, then the light will shut off, and that will complete the routine, and so we'll see batch complete show on the display. So let's go ahead and add some weight, and we're going to get to 5,000 pounds, which will exceed our 4,750, and we see that the light comes on, and in 3 seconds it's off, and we see batch complete on the display. When we're in a batch routine, the set points are going to be, shall we say, looked at or evaluated for their criteria in a numerical order. So, for example, we have a 1280 sitting here, and the 1280 has 100 set points that you are able to configure. And regardless of which set point you start with, whether you start with number one or you happen to start with something somewhere else for whatever reason, say 17, if that's the first configured set point in a batch routine, then when you start the batch, that'll be the first set point that it is going to look at. And when it moves on to the next configured set point after meeting the criteria of that first one, it'll go to whatever the very next configured set point is until it's gotten through all of the configured set points and reaches an end, and at that point the batch routine would be complete and it would tell us that on the display. In a free running set point, or a set point that is set outside of a batch routine, these are always being evaluated. So it doesn't matter whether a batch routine is running or not, the scale is going to be taking a look at what the criteria is based on those things. So that gives you an idea of what a set point is. Again, it's just a step in a process, and along with that step has a little bit of criteria that has to be met before moving on to the next step. And so we can use a series of set points together, and again, what we call a routine, to control a certain process that you might have in your environment, and we can let the scale do the work. And so that's a little bit about what a set point is.